We want to perform exponential regression to find a function to model the mobile broadband traffic in a state, and then use the model to predict the broadband traffic in 2014. Looking at the table, notice how the first year given is 2006. This is the base year, and instead of using the entire year as the input, we normally let the base year be the input of 0, and then since the year's increased by 1, we would have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 as the inputs. So these inputs represent the number of years after 2006, which we'll let equal t. The outputs of the function values will be the amount of traffic in terabytes. So for the first step, we want to enter the data into the calculator. So I'll press the stat key and then enter. To save some time, I've already entered the data, but let's say, for example, we had old data in the first column, which represents the inputs. We could go to the top of the column, press clear, and then enter, and then enter the new data. So for here, I'll re-enter 0 through 4. Next, even though it's not required, I want to graph a scatter plot of the data so we can graph the model right on top of the scatter plot. To do this, we do have to adjust the window, though, so that these values will show on the screen. Again, I've already done this. Notice how the inputs fall between the values of negative 1 and positive 5 for the x min and max. And notice that the outputs or function values fall between negative 8,000 and positive 70,000. Notice how I did make the y minimum negative because I do like to see the origin on the coordinate plane. To turn the scatter plot on, as long as the data is in L1 and L2, we can press y equals, press the up arrow, press enter on plot 1, and then back down. Notice how it's now highlighted, which means the scatter plot is turned on. So if we press graph, here's our scatter plot. But our main goal is to find the exponential function that fits this data. So now we'll do that. We'll press the stat key, right arrow to calculate. We're going to arrow down to exponential regression, which I believe is number 9. No, it's 0. So now we're going to press enter. And before I press enter again, I do want to store this equation in y1. So I'm going to press vars, right arrow once, enter, enter. And now this will give me the regression function as well as store it in y1. So now I'll press enter. So here's the value of a and b for our exponential function. Notice r squared, the coefficient of determination, is very close to 1, which means this is a good model for the data. Let's go ahead and round the values of a and b to 4 decimal places for our exponential function. So this would give us the exponential function f of t equals 1,345.8716 times 2.8238 raised to the power of t, where t equals the number of years after 2006, and f of t equals the traffic in terabytes. Now before we go back to the calculator, let's determine the value of t to make the prediction for 2014. T is going to be equal to 2014 minus the base year of 2006. So t is equal to 8 to make the prediction for 2014. So we need to find f of 8. But before we do this, since we stored the function in y1, if we press the graph key, we can see the graph of our exponential function right on the scatter plot, and we can see how well the graph does fit the data. And now to evaluate the function at t equals 8, because we have the function in y1, we can press second mode to go back to the home screen, press the vars key, right arrow once to y vars, and then enter, enter, which brings y1 to the home screen, and now we can just enter 8 in parentheses, just like function notation. But we should be aware, this is going to use the function provided here with all these extra decimal places. So it will give us a different answer than if we used our function here where we used rounded values. So we will compare the two function values, but let's go ahead and use the more accurate one. Rounded to the nearest terabyte, this would be 5,441,359, which would be the prediction for the year 2014. Now let's see how different this value would be if we used our function to determine the value of f of 8. Notice how there's a slight difference. Using our function, we would have a value of 5,440,955 terabytes. So just be aware there is a slight difference based upon which function we use. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.